Coming up next, Igor Vladimirovich versus Ian Hibbs.
Ian Hibbs, 17 years old, generally fights at 135 pounds, was set to fight at 135 pounds today. About 12 hours ago, decided, hey, I'm going to make a change, stepped up, stepped into this 155 amateur title fight, and, looking to make a very, very big statement in front of some hometown fans and, just show what's in store for the rest of the division.
Absolutely. He did the work. He showed up. He wanted to make weight, if not make me weight, and he's ready to go. Doesn't matter who it's against. He wants to get in there. He wants to get that experience. And wants to be a 135 peak champion in the future. So let's see if he can get that 155 belt first.
Try to get nice, Chad. Trying to get chased by the police and arrested. Just need a spot where we can kick it. A spot where we belong. That's just for us. As if they gotta get all dressed up and be Hollywood. You know what I mean? Where them niggas go when we die? Ain't no heaven for a thug, you know? That's why we go to Thug Mansion. That's the only place where thugs get in free, and you gotta be a G.
I place to spend my quiet nights. Time to unwind, so much pressure in this life of mine. I cried times I once contemplated how to swoosh and would have tried, but when I held that eye, all I could see was my mama's eyes. No one knows my struggle, they only see the trouble. Not knowing it's hard to carry on when no one loves you. Picture me inside the misery and poverty. No man alive has ever witnessed struggles I survived. Praying hard for better days, promise to hold on. Me and my dogs ain't have a choice but to roll on. We found a final spot to kick it, where we can drink liquor and know a victor's over the trick ish. A spot where we can roast peace. Even though we cheese, we still visualize places that we can roll a piece. And in my mind's eye, I see this place the players going past. I got a spot for us all, so we can roll at the match. Will I survive all the fights in the darkness? Trouble sparks. But tell me, home is where the heart is.
Vladimirovich done work significantly thicker, we'll say.
Yes.
A little bit more built up, but that's also the
attention by the Arkansas Athletic Commission, Commissioner Mr. John Webb. The official fight brought to you by the official PFC Shop Gear. Gear up like the OG with the apparel of the Peak Fighting Shop available on our merch display or thepeakfighter.com. This fight is scheduled for 3 rounds and it's for the PFC Lightweight Championship. First, to you in the blue corner, he is a freestyle fighter holding a record of 1-0. Standing at 5'7" tall, weighing in at 154 pounds, fighting out of Texarkana in Hibbs. And his opponent, out of the red corner, he is a Muay Thai fighter holding a record of 3-1-1. Standing at 5'10" tall, weighing at 155 pounds, fighting out of Lufkin, Texas. This is Mr. Igor Vladimirovich.
We got both of these people's support systems right next to each other, so we'll see who's louder.
Oh, it's so loud back here.
Just a reminder, this is for the lightweight title, all title fights, five rounds instead of the traditional three.
You know, with Ian being a little bit lighter, he may be a little bit quicker than Igor, so we'll see if that's going to help avoid some of those heavy punches from Igor.
He's either going to have to get in the pocket of Igor and trade.
The very right hand from Ian looked like it actually stunned Igor a little bit.
Yeah, good striking, but good job right here by Igor.
And Ian is very quick on his feet.
Igor switching stances a little bit.
Good slip by Ian.
Oh, great counter there. And Tally, as a fighter in this situation, how important are these first minute of this fight for him?
It's extremely important. Like I said, it can be a little scary with going against someone so big, so much bigger, so you don't want to get in there and just get these heavy punches. You want to establish your range, keep moving, make Igor chase you and kind of tire him out a little bit.
And that's exactly what I see Ian doing right now. Sometimes the bigger fighter doesn't always have the powerful punches.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's just because he's bigger doesn't mean he hits harder. Absolutely.
And we also know that, you know, placement is everything, right?
Yes. Ian looks like he's touched. Ooh. He's got touched up a little bit.
Well, Igor doing a great job of backing Ian up, but then Ian just ducks under for a great takedown and moves into a side control position.
We've seen that a couple times tonight. Perfect timing under the left hand to get straight into that double leg and takes him down every time.
And
if Igor holds himself like this, he might tire his arms out.
Well, now it's out. Because at a certain point, you got to worry about going to the bomb through as well.
Good side.
Great scramble. Wow. Great scramble by Ian, but a very good transition back into the closed guard by Igor.
And again, it can be a little bit easier for Ian, being the smaller fighter. They can stay on top and just kind of ride on top of Igor. Yeah, surf on top. But he definitely doesn't want Igor on top of him because he can use his weight to kind of tire him out and just stay heavy on him.
And Ian's doing a really good job of like sinking into those hips now.
Nice step over.
Yeah, very good step over into that half guard. Good cross face. We've got 10 seconds left in the very first round here.
Again, with those 10 seconds left, kind of just get those points, throw some punches in. Nice. That probably felt really good for Ian to finish on top.
Absolutely. So a pretty back and forth round, but it ends with Ian Hibbs, the 17-year-old, on top.
Now Craig Campbell looks to be telling Ian to be taking nice big deep breaths. He got through the first round with Igor, and now Igor's taking some pretty deep breaths. At first, when he went to his corner, I didn't see him really...
He's breathing out of his mouth. And he's taking some big breaths in
good
there.
Big breaths, yeah.
So if I'm Igor right now, what do we think his coaches are telling him in the corner?
You know, I think he needs to be a little bit quicker and keep that movement. Don't rely on those heavy punches to finish him. He knows now, you know what, this is going to be a fight. Ian's coming out ready to go, so he's going to have to stay and keep a pace with it.
Ian is smaller but faster.
Yes.
And so it's hard to hit a target that's moving so fast like Ian. And he's very slick with getting out of that range.
That being said, he is also less experienced, and we saw a couple times where Igor rushed him down with some volume that Ian didn't seem to like that too much. And a nice body shot laid from Igor, but Igor does a great job of transitioning into the back And now, working to drop hands down for a double leg.
Nice slam. Oh, that was good. Right in the corner.
And a great slam by Ian Hibbs to take top control over Igor Vladimirovich here in the second round.
It was a palm over the mouth. Yeah, I was gonna say that can be kind of hard because Igor was trying to get some space to stand up, but you're doing that open-handed, so it can slip in.
And you can see it right there.
Oh, it's gosh. Good to push on the head like that, but of course you do gotta be careful, very careful in fingers.
So what would be interesting now is what position do they put them back in?
Well, an eye poke is now, and Igor is flipping the crowd off over here. So an eye poke regulation series wise is now considered just as bad as a groin shot, so you can get 5 minutes or...
But when that eye poke occurred, and from the replay we see he got one in both eyes, actually, but when they resume, are they going to put Ian back on top? Are they going to put them back down on the ground? Are they going to start from a neutral position? Because, in my opinion, Ian Hibbs was in the dominant position and would not have lost if it wasn't for that foul.
Right. No, I agree.
And it looks like they are going to start them off standing.
Our rep is going to answer your question. Just really, it's a matter of questioning how severe the eye pokes were.
Oh, a big right hand!
Ian is doing a great job with that right hand, straight down the middle every time, and it is stopping Igor in this pose.
And you can see right now, Igor trying to use his size to kind of sprawl against his, keep that takedown from happening. Igor just misses, a little bit out of range.
Igor is getting a little desperate now, leaning forward for those shots. Dang.
Good head movement there by both fighters.
Yeah, Igor's doing really well where he's actually kicking first and then finishing with those punches.
I know someone else that likes to use that technique.
It works, it really does.
And again, if I'm Igor, I want more of that. If I'm his corner, I'm telling him, let's get some more volume on him. Let's push him backwards and make him fight off his back foot. Oh, what a slip on that to get the double or to get the takedown.
Perfect timing.
We've seen a lot of that tonight across all the fights. Is fighters using that head movement in the takedown.
And with only 45 seconds to go, which is actually really nice. That's a Igor's getting a little, all right, I'm going to call it out. Igor's getting a little dirty over here.
He will have to be very careful with
needs
all
to be
of
careful.
Yeah.
He does.
Fingers away from Orify. Or orifices.
It's very, okay, look, it is hard when someone is, now
he's punching open
hand. Ian is getting over on Igor on a few of these exchanges, and it's really getting to Igor's
and you can
head.
See it's frustrating.
It's very frustrating, and hey.
So 5 seconds left in the second round.
Unexpected as well. You know, I think Igor was expecting to come out
and
to now be on such a defensive, you know, state.
And just a reminder to everyone at home, the clock you see on the TV is unofficial. So for anyone wondering why there's a little bit of a differentiation, the commission does keep the official time. Now, for the second round in a row, Ian Hibbs ends on top.
Peppering shots and building up those points.
And passing.
And again, we have five rounds. So I think it's really nice that Ian is getting those takedowns right at the end of the round. So he now has a minute to kind of gather himself. It's not like spending the whole round trying to hold down such a big guy.
So, again, Ian Hibbs looks very relaxed in there. He's still, you know, he has his breath under control.
He's standing. He is ready.
Yes, to where he would like a little bit. Not breathing as hard as it looked like he was last round. Maybe that break from the eye poke plays a factor into that, but you know, again, it'll be interesting to see how this fight goes as we near the halfway point.
I'm curious to see the adjustments that Igor's corner has given him.
Again, because Igor has been dangerous multiple times in this fight.
Very much so.
Ooh, again, that right hand is really connecting for Hibbs.
Really good circling out there, displaying.
You know,
by
I do
Ian.
Notice Igor seems to be a little heavy.
Look at the sprawl by Ian.
Shoots in for a takedown, but it's sprawled and defended by Hibbs, and now he has cage control. Vladimirovich spins it around.
Again, able to use his
leg.
Hibbs takes the back of beautiful little hip drop. That was Slick Rick, boys. Slick Rick.
Yoshihiro off the other action. And here we go for the choke.
No,
now, when it's not in on his left side, you only have one hook in.
And it's kind of nice for Igor. He's in his corner, so he's able to hear his coaches clearly and get that advice of what he needs to do.
Well, we saw Igor do that as he kind of throws himself towards the corner, so he could one, use the fence, and two,
nice using those knees.
Igor doing a good job of sending body shots against Hibbs. Because the thing about those body shots is they open up the head shots in a lot of cases. Good shoulder pressure here against the king.
Yeah, I think this is where Igor wants to be because, again, he can use his weight to hold Ian against the cage.
Oh, well, Ian had a gable grip on a single leg, but isn't able to do it. And Gene goes for that little...
Right, the Gene goes for again.
Gets for that inside kick again, but it's not there this time.
The open stance there before with Ian was so solid. You can see the chain wrestling reactions from Ian Hibbs.
And there's that, and now he tries to set up a head and arm choke, but he's not going to have room because
the cage. Yeah, the cage is in the way.
Which is a shame because Hibbs in a very good position for that initially.
And again, we're here at 45 seconds on our clock. Hibbs on top, Igor on bottom.
Right, we are past halfway of this fight.
It's always interesting as the opponent in your opponent's corner, because you're listening to their coaches and you're seeing what he wants to do. That's where it's really good to have those code words and kind of code phrases so your opponent doesn't know exactly what you're trying to do, what the coaches are telling you to do.
In the words of Joshua Fabian, I need that Tyson. And again, 10 seconds left in the third round here. Hibbs looks pretty happy to be in that.
Nice grab and pound.
Couple nice hammer fists to the face of Igor Vladimirovich. And again, for the third round in a row, Ian Hibbs, 17 years old, ends on top.
Wow, he is just walking off. He's got this in the bag, I think, and he knows it. Now, we've seen plenty of fights because there's still two more rounds. The coast or finish.
And again, even if any of these guys' fights have gone the distance in the past, neither guy has been here before.
Absolutely.
Neither guy has been to a fourth round before. Neither guy has been to a fifth round before. So it'll be interesting to see how they take that. Vladimirovich does look like he's breathing heavier again this round. So I think that IPO in the second round definitely helped the cardio a little bit.
And again, Ian is keeping such composure. You can tell he knows what he's doing. He feels very comfortable in there. And I think after every round, he's getting more and more confident that he can be in here with the big boys.
And our officials.
Championship rounds, let's see.
Championship rounds. Saw Vladimirovich getting wiped down by the official there. Thought we saw some jelly that got where it wasn't supposed to be. And now we start the fourth round.
This has been a very technical fight.
But see, that is what Igor needs to keep doing. That's what we need more.
And a great transition again by Igor. Got a little high, shaking off the top.
Yep.
It's hard in these last couple rounds because you're slippery, so I think he was able to just slip right out of that.
Hibbs, again.
Looks like really heavy shoulder pressure there. Look at him getting at the body, just doing some peppering shots.
The wrestling and the jiu-jitsu transitions from Ian Hibbs have been unbelievably impressive.
Absolutely.
And I owe him a public apology for calling him a white belt earlier.
He's like, let me show you Remington Steel. Wow.
So, Hibbs on top, we're up from half guard. Vladimirovich looking to get his friends in.
And Hibbs is very active on top. It's something that you don't really often see with amateur fighters. Look at the chain reactions to moving from wrestling, jiu-jitsu.
Well, and it's, again, all those passes, chaining them together.
Igor is up. Amazing. He took that little relief of pressure and was able to just pop right on up.
And that's where the weight definitely makes a difference.
Hibbs drops down to a single leg. Hasn't fully finished it yet, and now what? Vladimirovich shifts into that closed guard.
And I do like those little palm strikes. I think they are very effective.
Well, they can build over time.
For sure. Well, and it's little things like that, right? Like, if my opponent's launching offense, it makes it a little bit difficult for me to launch my offense as well.
Yes.
Right?
And getting those palm strikes to your ear can be very annoying, and they do hurt.
Absolutely. So, 1 minute left in the fourth round. Vladimirovich looks like he was trying to set up some kind of shoulder lock there, but that goes by the wayside. So, Hibbs still in the closed guard, looking to posture up. Vladimirovich looks like he's trying to set up an arm bar as Hibbs trying to posture up, but he uses that opportunity to pass.
This has been a very technical fight to the fact where Ian will go wherever Igor wants to go, but also dictate the ground exchanges and is really good at slipping and staying out of range of Igor on the feet.
Well, he's responding when he has to, and he's dictating when he can. Oh. Yeah, 10 seconds left in this fourth round.
Wow.
As Hibbs looks to walk in the rear end and chase him. Let's find out. And so for the fourth round in a row, Ian Hibbs ends on top, and arguably, Igor Vladimirovich, a man twice his age, is potentially saved by the bat. Oh my, oh. Looking back at the replays here, there's that great sprawl into the takedown. And we see Ian working from that kind of half quarter guard type position. What do you think's been the difference so far here, Tom?
I think, like I said, Igor was expecting to come out and bully this kid.
Absolutely.
And I think Ian has just been a little too quick. And he's been extremely technical.
Absolutely. Ian has a lot of colors in his crayon box. He's got a variety of shades.
Absolutely. So, we enter the fifth and final round. And I think it's pretty safe to say Igor Vladimirovich needs a finish.
He does. But, you know, he's still in the fight.
He is absolutely still in the fight.
He just stood there, took a deep breath. Mentally, he is still in the fight. He is going to try.
Great jab there. But again, as Vladimirovich tries to walk the young fighter backwards.
And Ian needs to coast.
This is the time to play it safe.
Or finish.
Oh my gosh! Wow, that was a perfect defense from Igor. Just slipped right under that head.
Athleticism from both men at its finest. And I think it's safe to say, regardless of your age, you take a fight 20 pounds heavier on 12 hours notice, you're a man now. Mm-hmm. And again, Vladimirovich being warned by the official. I didn't quite see what this one was. Let's see if we can kind of listen in a little bit to this conversation.
To the groin. Knee to the groin.
So, Ian Hibbs taking his time. Now, The only thing about this,
you can't take
Ian Hibbs did look like the fresher fighter, and we look back at this potential foul right here. So, 2 minutes left in this fifth and final round.
You know, and I think for both of these guys, they were preparing for a completely different fighter.
Oh, absolutely.
So to have to, on the fly, create a new game plan and go in there without really having a chance to study these fighters or spar with their training partners that are similar is very hard to do.
Absolutely.
And this just shows how versatile they are as fighters, both of them.
Hibbs looking a little bit gassy.
Yeah, that was a good combo from Igor, that he was able to keep him on the cage with that.
Yep. So halfway through this fifth and final round, as Ian Hibbs is falling, yells for him to punch Igor in the face. Hibbs drops down for finger line, and he's going to get the takedown, transition to a back kick.
Igor.
Oh, great roll out from that, a great landing roll. But Hibbs is hot to it.
Okay, he's got one
hook in, one hook in, two hooks in. Transitions to that sit-down position now. And he's going to want to look to use that left hand. But Igor doing a good job in striking.
Oh.
And that is on the jaw.
Love the audience.
Very close. So 30 seconds left in this fifth and final round. Ian Hibbs looking to finish this fight, not leave any doubt.
And now Igor's done a great job of defending all of these submission attempts.
Wow.
By Ian Hibbs right now, I am very happy here. I do not understand that under any circumstances. Less than 10 seconds to go in the official clock. As Hibbs transitions for another
yourself, and Ian Hibbs displayed a perfect effort tonight,
and he really displayed himself as a professional fighter.
100%.
I would have expected him to be a professional fighter. I think that was an amazing performance to put on in your amateur career.
And to see a few things happen, an eye poke, almost fish hook, a groin shot. His mentality, his mental stability was solid.
Shook it all off. Absolutely.
That kind of comes into play with being young. I don't know if you can, but you know, nothing fazes you when you're young. Nothing ever worries you. And here's our official decision.
And your new PFC lightweight champion in the blue corner from Texarkana, Ian Hibbs.
All right, I am standing here with your new peak amateur lightweight champion, 17 years old, Ian Hibbs. Ian, congratulations on an amazing fight. We talked a little bit about kind of the lead up to this, but a lot of people may not know. You traditionally fight at 135 pounds. You were set to fight someone else about 12 hours ago, and you decided to step up and take this fight on short notice, two weight classes up against a man about twice your age. How do you feel, and what led you to take this fight? Why on earth would you make that decision?
You gotta dare to be great. You know, fortune favors the brave. And I was like, why not? You know, I have the skills. I've been training since I was 7. This is my job. I'm homeschooled, and this is what I do all day. 7 to 8 hours a day. So, yeah.
So, I need you to let this sink in. You are the 155 pound champion. What's the next move?
I'm gonna relinquish this shit. I'm relinquishing it tonight. I'm going back down to 35. Yeah.
Okay, well, the PFC amateur lightweight belt is now vacant.
I might save it till I get the 35, be PFC's first double champ. We'll have to see.
Hey. Well, we look forward to whatever it is. Congratulations on a great performance.
And I have to say, so far, that may have been fight of the night. Definitely performance of the night for me and Hibbs. Wow, such an accomplishment. To be able to overcome, step up, and put on a show like that is beyond impressive.
I honestly don't know what to say about that. In full transparency, I'm pretty blown away by the performance. Not only, regardless of what happened, unbelievably impressive from Ian Jens taking this fight.
No, but I was saying, I think he looked like pro quality. Definitely. Pro performance he just put on.
And again, there was no question to this fight. He was dominant. But now, Igor Vladimirovich did a great job at times on the feet.
Absolutely.
He definitely hurt Ian a couple times. He definitely made Ian adjust. But again, just the poise and the fight IQ from a kid that's 17 years old and has only had one fight. Well, one MMA fight before, obviously an expensive kickboxing guy. But again, just talk about a prodigy.
Absolutely. You know, we have some amazing bantamweights, featherweights in this peak division. So let's see if he can translate that into the 135 division. You know, he just showed us that he could do 155. I know he wants to do 135 and become a 135 champ.
Yeah. And I mean, at this point, you have to give him that fight, right?
Yeah.
you can't give him that fight, right? So, like we were kind of mentioning before, in theory, Ian Hibbs drops down to 135 pounds. So Ian Hibbs wins the 155 belt tonight. In theory, he drops down to 135 pounds. Let's say he wins that. Maybe he goes back, meets it in the middle to 145 belt, right? And then we potentially have a three weight class champion on our hands.
Yeah, and hasn't even made his pro debut yet.
Wow.
I am curious, though, with him fighting 155ers, I'm wondering how these bantamweights, the 135ers, will feel. Obviously, he's not a huge, you know, bantamweight, so I don't think that is, like, extremely, intimidating. But to know he went toe-to-toe with a 155er, it's got to be definitely a little intimidating for these 35ers.
Absolutely. I honestly, just looking at it from a broad strokes perspective, one of the biggest challenges for Ian Hibbs going forward is to find people that will fight him.
Absolutely.
Because I know for a fact, if I'm managing a fighter and they offered me Ian Hibbs, I'm turning that down.
Yeah, I'm going to think twice about that. Like I said, because that's what we do as fighters. You go to the profile, you see who they have fought. So to fight someone like Igor, that is not an easy fight for him to do. Like I said, he was not prepared to be fighting Igor and two weight classes up. So for him to be able to do that basically on the fly is going to be, like I said, very intimidating for these other bantamweights.
And